Meisa Salaita, and I'm here at Georgia Aquarium, where one of the most important jobs is making sure all the animals are properly taken care of, including making sure that they get enough to eat and not too much to eat. So I'm here with Steve, and we are feeding some stingrays.
These are actually our resident four black lodge fantail stingrays, born right here in our Ocean Voyager habitat.
Imagine being in charge of feeding an entire town where everyone has different likes and dislikes, a variety of dietary needs, and appetites ranging from a little hungry to ravenous.
Wow!
There are tens of thousands of animals on site, from these tiny sea dragons to the massive whale sharks, and from these low-key spider crabs to high-energy dolphins. Together, they consume more than 500,000 pounds of food a year. So ordering, choosing, preparing, and serving the food is a huge responsibility. It all starts here at the commissary, where animal care staff prepare such delicacies as krill, capelin, and squid.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing well, thanks. What do we have here?
Nutritionist Dr. Lisa Hoops oversees the animal's dietary needs.
So in this bin, we've got our fatty herring, which goes to our belugas.
Not so fat.
Yeah.
It's not so fat.
Well, compared to this little guy, maybe, right?
Okay.
Right? And this is our Pacific herring. This would go to something more like our penguin species.
Okay.
We've got some mackerel and some capelin. So this will be our fattiest fish here, and so that's important in terms of calories and making sure that we're getting the right amount of calories to our animals here.
And so do you look at the animal and see what size it is and decide it needs a certain amount of calories based on the size, or how does that work?
It's based on what species we're talking about, how they control their internal body temperature. It has to do with their activity level and their growth stage. There's a lot of factors that go into understanding caloric needs for an animal.
Proper nutrition is considered preventative medicine and is an essential component to keeping our animals healthy. The beluga whales need to eat a lot and often, between 30 and 60 pounds each day, depending on their size, their age, gender, and the season. The emerald tree boas, on the other hand, are only fed once a month, standard for snakes.
So now you know what they feed these animals, but just how do these creatures eat? Well, each one has its own unique feeding habits.
Just look at whale sharks. Sometimes growing to more than 40 feet long, whale sharks are the largest fish in the ocean, but they like to chow down on some of the smallest organisms in the sea.
Woo! Let's go over there, buddy!
They have massive mouths, but their throats are super narrow, about the size of a quarter. So their preferred food is tiny creatures like krill, fish eggs, and really small fish.
This is a really gigantic creature. You've seen some of the factors that might influence how much an animal eats. Let's see if size and water temperature make a difference too. We'll also look at how metabolic rate might influence the amount of food an animal eats.
Okay. Let's compare one of Georgia Aquarium's estimated 2,000-pound whale sharks to one of my favorite animals, the sea otter, weighing in at around 65 pounds. You would think the sea otter must eat a lot less, right? Let's take a closer look. An adult whale shark eats about 45 pounds a day, while an adult sea otter eats about 13 pounds. So for the whale shark, that's just over 2% of its body weight, and 20% for the sea otter. Now that's impressive for an animal 30 times smaller. So what's really going on? It turns out that sea otters have a much higher metabolism than whale sharks. That means they transform food into energy more quickly, and they need more fuel to keep their internal engines running.
As you can see, you can't judge just how much an animal is going to eat by looking at them. And even if you know how much they eat, you still have to know the best way to feed them.
There's target feeding, which is more like waiter service. Animals are all fed one by one to control the amount of food and calories. However they get their food, the point is to make sure every animal gets enough food to stay healthy and to grow.
We've learned what many of the animals here at Georgia Aquarium eat and how the crew figures out just how much they need. And now that you know too, it's your turn to decide what's gonna go on the menu and just how much. So see you next time, and remember, science is all around you. Until then,